المسيح، المسيح عيسى ابن مريم، the messenger of Allah whom we love dearly. And I hope this message goes out to the Christians who have a major misconception about Islam and the Muslims. They think we are the enemies and we are this and we are that, and they fail to know that the only religion which believes in Jesus besides Christians or Christianity is Islam. The Jews don't believe in him, the Hindus don't believe in him, the Buddhists don't believe in him, and the atheists don't believe in anything except the shayateen. But the Muslims believe in Jesus. And not only that, no, we believe in him and we believe in everything concerning him, some of which are unique to Jesus, not matched by any other prophet. And some of them you will see now. It's enough that he will be the one coming at the end of time. And he will kill the Dajjal. And he will rule. And he will live by the Islamic legislation. And that he is alive. That he wasn't crucified. That he was born miraculously from the Virgin Mary. That he spoke at birth. All of these are in the Quran and the Sunnah. No Christian has to beg us to believe. Thereafter, please believe. We already believe. You have to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We already believe in what you have. You have to believe in what we have. Why? Because we didn't bring it from home. The one who revealed unto you what to believe about Jesus is the one who revealed unto you what to believe about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you look at their messages, they are identical. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is the first commandment. This is La ilaha illallah. This is Islam. We are on the same page. But we have to understand that and come to Islam while maintaining our belief in Jesus. We just have to modify. Is he God? No way. No way is a man born from a woman. No way he can be God. And no way that a man born from a woman can be the son of God. Because for a woman to deliver God, she must be God. And if the woman was God, that means that human beings are God. If God is like humans, we no longer have a God, because by definition, God is the creator of human beings. I mean, you totally get lost. So, you know, think about it, and it will make a lot of sense to you. Now Allah says in the Quran concerning Jesus, وَإِنْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكُونُ عَلَيْهِ شَهِيدًا. And there is none of the people of the scripture except that he must believe in him, Jesus, before his death. Before the death of who? It could be the death of Jesus or the death of that person from the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians. Now, Abu Huraira narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, I swear by Allah, Isa, Jesus, the son of Mary, will indeed descend judging mankind with justice. Not as they believe he will judge mankind on the day of resurrection. No, he will rule this world as a ruler, and he will be applying justice. And we will see in some of the traditions. It says here that after he kills the Dajjal, he will break the cross. He will break the cross, because the whole concept of the cross is fabricated, because Jesus was never crucified. And let us say, hypothetically speaking, he was crucified. This becomes the means of his torture. This becomes the machine on which he was killed. Do you magnify that, or do you hate it and detest it? If your son, la qadra, someone's relative was electrocuted with an electric chair, do you go buy one and put it around your neck? Or every time you see it, you become sad and you hate seeing it because it reminds you of your relative? The second. So if it is claimed that he was killed on this cross, why is the cross being worshipped beside Allah? Why are the people prostrating, and why are they doing all these things to it? So Jesus rejects this in totality, because he was never calling people to Trinity, nor did he tell them that I will die for your sins and you'll be saved with my death. Never. When he was asked about how shall I, in Matthew chapter 19 verses 16 and 17, when he was asked, oh good master, how shall I, you know, enter into the eternal life? He said, keep the commandments. He said to the Jews, you know, until your righteousness, verily, verily, I say unto you, except your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you should by no means enter the kingdom of God. Unless you are more righteous than the Jews, Salah, Siyam, Hajj, Umrah, you will not enter paradise. He was telling people, believe and do righteous deeds, you will enter paradise. So he will break the cross, he will abolish the jizya, which is a tax, taxation collected from subjected disbelievers. And the prostration of the prostration will be only one for Allah, the Lord of the universe. No one will worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani all the other religions will be abolished, the whole people will be upon Islam for some time, that is. When people worship, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will perform Hajj and Umrah. He will perform Hajj and Umrah. All this is confirmed in the Sahih